Hi, back again. Today I'm going to be using Soap Commander Intuition. Give it a go. Got a sample. Give it a try. And the razor today is the 1979-1980 Gillette Tech. Says made in England on it anyway. And the blade I'll be using is the Gillette Wilkinson sword. Just going to lather up. I'll be back. Just goes lather on it. Nice lather. But it's very... There's not a strong smell to it. It might change when I put it on my face, this intuition, but I can't find any information about it. And I don't think Soap Commander make it anymore. I bought the sample. But there's bergamot, floral, and tonka bean. That's all I know that's in it. So... have to see. So I don't know if I make it anymore. I don't know. Or I just poured it all myself. So put this mirror up a bit. That's better. There's more. How can I say it? There's not much of a scent to this. Hey. Now, I can pick up the base note of the soap itself. Must have been one of the ingredients, is palm oil. It's good lather. But there's supposed to be bergamot this, but Gillette Tech. Right, that's how we got it. Oh, I feel mild. Very mild. I've got a blade in it. Yes, I have. Good lather, it's slick. Good razor. Very mild though. It's a slick soap. I can smell slight something like a slight lime coming through, so that'd be the bergamot, right? But floral. It's yeah, slight lime, and there's a slight, slight woody, I wouldn't say musky, but and I wouldn't say leathery, no, because I can't. No, it's not there. Hard to pick out anything on it. The sample could be for an old batch, you know, it's, I don't know. Right, across the grain. There's no blade feel with this razor. It's very mild. Probably still nicky though. Still efficient though. Thank you. because I think this Salt Command is glycerin based, isn't it? It's a vegan sort of. Very strong smell of palm oil in it though, which will be from the glycerin. It's a good performing soap. But I smell more palm oil, you know. You have to really concentrate to pick anything up because it's just I picked a slight bit of lime, which, you know, citrus then. And it just flutters off into the distance and so would I buy this? Nah. Not this one anyway. I couldn't buy it now anyway because by all the looks on their website, don't sell it now. It must be discontinued. Or they changed the name. But the performance of the soap, though, I can't grumble. This odd, there's a word, nuances. You know, how can I put it, my? When, I don't know if you get it, you know, how can I put it, right? There's a lead belief when you got, say, loved ones that have passed on, right, passed on. And then you remember what kind of perfumes and scents, deodorant, whatever, or their body, their skin, aroma, whatever. And when they passed on, and then years later, and you think, you know, and you get them nuances, and you'll get that scent where you walk, bloody hell, you know. And this is what it's like with this soap. I'm talking shit now, isn't it? But that's the only way I can explain it. It's just like a slight smell comes and then all of a sudden it just disappears again, you know. Against the green. Don't think I'm going to do a head shape with this one. I don't know how that would go though. Thank you. But that's the best way I can explain it, is where you've got a loved one that's passed on, and you remember the scents they wore, colognes, perfumes, whatever, and you get that odd whiff, and, you know, this is what the soap's like. There's 1 minute there's nothing there, and all of a sudden and it comes out, but and it just disappears again, and there's nothing. See, it's there again. Floral note. Oh, I nicked myself. Bloody hell. It's a good soap, but they should call it Afterlife. I'm not being funny, but it's just like odd whiffs of, you know. You see, it's there again, the odd floral note, woodsy note, just comes and goes. Yeah. Citrus. And then gone again. Right, this is pickups. Oh, And this soap is really slick. There you go. Shave. I'll just go in to do a head shave. Be back. Hi, back. Head shave. It's not a perfect, you're not going to get BBS with this razor. Unless you want razor burn. You're not going to get it. But other than that, it was a good shave for what it is. It's a good razor. 1979-1980 Gillette Tech. Plastic handle. And do you see it? No. It says made in England anyway. Yeah, that's a good razor. Right, did I just, no, I'm not going to do the alum today because the last couple of days my hair has been dry, so I'm going to give it a miss today. Oh, there's a little hair here. Bloody hell. You go over it and go over it and it's, I tried it. But it was good. For what it is, it's a good razor. What am I using today? Aftershave. I thought I'd use Marks and Spencer's Wood Spice Gentleman Burgundy. Nice aftershavers. Yeah, very, won't be quiet with this because my brother bought it me. So only use it now again. Ooh, plenty of alcohol in there. Oh. Beautiful stuff. Nice. What did we do? Lovely stuff. Oh, you can smell the floral and the woody Hints of citrus and all sorts of goodies in it. And then to finish off, the Burgundy, well, Wood Spice Gentleman Burgundy aftershave balm. That's enough.
Peace eyes.
They're all really joking. Lovely stuff. One back on the angle there. But after all that, it'll settle down. But it's not exactly BBS, but it's a good shave. So that was the 1979-1980 Gillette Tech. They came with a shaving set, didn't they? Yeah. That's what mine came with, a shaving set, but I've got the 1960s Gillette Tech and the 1940s Gillette Tech and now a 1980s Gillette Tech. Well, bye now. Take care all. Thanks for watching.